Nation. We have the right to think the way we think. I wouldn't say that the older generation are better, but let's be very frank. If the young generation are as good as they are, I think they owe us a debt of gratitude.
Impressed me about Elman, and I remember seeing a video of him playing, among other things, the humoresque of Dvořák, was his incredible bow division, that everything was in such order. And of course, now comes, you know, the great debate about the Elman sound and what made the Elman sound.
If you look at Elman, he's a really, really small guy with very thick fingers. And he places his fingers in a way I've never seen other people place their fingers. Like, he has nails on his left hand. Like, it looks like a guitarist's hand, you know. So he sort of grew his nails, I think, to give himself support so that when he put his fingers down flat, since his fingers had a lot of meat in them anyway, I couldn't do it, but, you know, he could put them down flat and get a full vibrato swing. And it's really interesting to see that, because he plays with the violin up, his fingers flat, and he's really short, so his arms are very short, so he's playing all the way out here like this, and he has to lower the scroll just to get into a high position.
Was so incredibly concerned with the way his violin sounded, because he was so sensitive to sound, that he would actually go, I don't know, once, twice a week to the violin adjuster and move the sound post.
I think that I probably do practice every morning with my pianist, Mr. Zeiger, about 2 hours, 2.5 hours.
And one day the story goes like this. He says, you know, they're rehearsing, and Misha tells Joseph, I can see that. Joseph, you're not playing in time. So he says, Maestro, but I am playing that. Let's do it again, you know. So they do it again. Stops him again. He says, you're not playing in time. But Maestro, I am playing in time. He says, maybe you're playing in time, but not in my time. Plague of his life was Heifetz, because, okay, Heifetz was 10 years younger, and Heifetz was this and that, okay, and before Heifetz, he was You know, he sold more records than practically anybody else.
Elman suffered from Heifetz disease. That was his problem. Fortunately or unfortunately, when Heifetz came on the scene, everybody suffered from the same kind of disease, which is, there is Heifetz, you know, what, you know, and all of a sudden everybody had to compare themselves to this incredible phenomenon. Listening to him, and I could not close my mouth for like a week. I couldn't believe what I was listening to. It was, and he of course looked very cool on the stage. You know, he didn't move much. He just moved what was necessary, and that was, in my estimation, the reason that people called him very cold.
And people would say, for example, about Heifetz, he was cold. Close your eyes and listen.
What you heard was, for me, I could describe it as like a tornado moving in one place, just staying, you know, with the most incredible heat coming out.
The thing was in the playing. How would you define? I could say that Joseph Hassett, in some ways, could have been more perfect in some ways. Milstein also sometimes. Heifetz did from time to time a note which wasn't exactly that. Thanks God. You know the story with the Bernard Shaw, who wrote to him a letter. Please do some false notes so that we know that you are human.
The sound was, it had a kind of a edge to it that in the concert hall just carried in the most beautiful, there was a lot of beauty to the sound, which actually does not exist as much on the recordings, because he insisted on having the microphone quite close. So you heard all of that, I know my old teacher used to call it the zhit sound, that right there, which got lost in the hall and just was a luminous, wonderful, wonderful sound.
Thank you.
Seifert's tone production has to do with bow speed. He moved the bow very, very quickly. He did not use a sort of as much bow pressure. This was a Russian way of doing it, you know, to moving the bow very, very quick and then getting this incredible, incredible edge to the sound.
I think since Heifetz and I guess Milstein as well, but particularly Heifetz, who could play so brilliantly and so cleanly, and you can hear every single note. It's not like it sounds brilliant and perfect, and then you listen closer and some notes are missing or some notes are just kind of passed over quickly. With Heifetz, it was all there.
Particularly when he played a concerto by Tchaikovsky, concerto by Wieniawski, works like that which suited him to perfection. He played certain things, even the Chaconne by Vitali. There is so much drama there, which is so expressive and so impressive, it makes you shudder almost. But of course, when it came to the classics, then that's a different world entirely.
You can like, not like, you can agree, not agree necessarily with everything that happens, but Heifetz was unique, there's no doubt.
I think that's so silly for a grown-up person to come out on the stage and scratch the violin. Really, I mean it. That's serious what they're saying.
That's what he says, but Nathan Milstein doesn't mean it. He's been playing for more than 60 years and is one of the supreme violinists of our age, a master of his instrument.
Nobody had the kind of concept of cleanliness of articulation that Milstein did, and he was absolutely, he was as intense as Elman was about tone. That's how intense Milstein was about articulation and cleanliness of between the notes.
Parce que lui passait tout son temps à chercher tout le temps. Chaque fois que je venais chez lui à la maison, je disais, tu sais, j'ai trouvé ça, regarde, c'est un nouveau truc, etc. Tout le temps, il cherchait. C'était comme un horloger.
With him, it was a way of life. With him, it was give me the fiddle and I'll just play it all the time. I'll just play it all the time, all the time. I'll doodle, 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 practice, practice, doodle, you know, do little things, you know, investigate, you know, try and see, let me see which passage, you know, if which fingering I should use that make the passage sound cleaner, some more articulated.
All the time he was all finds tricks, all new things. He would come, you know, I would come to his house. You know, at one time he lived in Paris for several months. We saw each other practically every night, every day, you know. I'd come here, Ivory, you know, I just thought.
That's it.
Circus, poker, or something.
Not at all, not at all. It's a military band passing the street in the small village. Let's go home.
Well, you could not love him if you knew him. I mean, he was, I don't know, I see there a little sign here that I don't know on the paper, I don't know why, but it says perfect. He was.
And he was absolutely nonchalant, kind of. That was a cool character when it came to playing the violin.